Hey everyone. In this example video, we are asked to approximate the definite integral of the function 4x squared plus 2x minus 1 over the interval 2 to 6 using the left Riemann sum with 4 equal subintervals. The first thing I'm going to do here is draw out our function so that we can visually see the steps that we are going to be applying. The polynomial function will look something like this, with our lower integration bound 2 and our upper integration bound 6. And we are trying to approximate the area under the curve within these bounds. The first step we need to do here is find our delta x, that being the spacing of our subintervals. Since we want equal spacing of our 4 subintervals, we are going to use the following equation, b minus a, which gives us our length of x over which we are integrating. Then we divide by our number of subintervals, which gives us 1. So let's add these onto our graph here on the left. Secondly, we need to develop our left Riemann sum equation to solve this problem. To do this, we begin with our general formula that was developed in our past Riemann sum theory video, which I will leave a link down in the description down below if you missed it. With equal subinterval spacing, our delta x becomes a constant, and we can factor it out in front of our summation term, therefore we get the following equation. Now, let's iterate through our summation notation from I equals 1 to I equals 4. So, as we go here, I will add the appropriate areas to our graph so that you can visualize it as we go. We begin with our constant, delta x, which we said can be factored out. Then, we will add a bracket and begin our summation at I equals 1. We have our function evaluated at x sub I minus 1, which is x naught. Therefore, this is saying our first rectangle's height depends on the function evaluated at x naught, which is this point here. So if we were to expand this equation, we would have delta x times f of x, which is this rectangle shown here. Now, let's move on to when I is equal to 2. Therefore, we add f of x 1, and correspond that on a graph like so. Then we can continue this trend for our next two terms until I equals 4, then we stop. Next, we need to actually know what these values in our equation are. To do this, we need to evaluate our given function at these inputs. Let's go ahead and do that. Plugging in our inputs and solving, we get the following table of input-output values. Lastly, we now have all the required variables and can solve for the area approximated under our curve here with our rectangles. Therefore, this definite integral is approximately equal to 240, and this is our final answer. Since we have all the information, we can actually check our answer with the exact solution using a definite integral calculator online, or actually solving it yourself. Doing so, we find that the analytical solution to this problem is 305.3. That means that our left Riemann sum is underestimating with a relative error of 21.4, which is not great. But this does make sense based on our schematic here. As we learned in the past theory video, with a monotonically increasing function, left Riemann sums will always underestimate our integral, which is obvious with these red regions here. So, if on a test you are asked how you might improve this error, you could say that by increasing our n value, increasing our subintervals, we can reduce our error proportionally. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a left Riemann sum problem. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.